When it comes to drug use among the nation's teens, the latest Monitoring the Future survey shows the need for continued concern.
The Monitoring the Future survey is the longest term survey that's been conducted and sponsored by the National Institute on Drug Abuse. It's been in existence for nearly 40 years, looking at trends in drugs, alcohol, and tobacco use amongst 8th, 10th, and 12th graders. The good news is that illegal drug use in this country amongst young people is down. The areas of concern is that marijuana use is up, and it has been for the past 5 years.
6.5%, or 1 in 15 high school seniors, smoke marijuana daily. That's up from 5.1% 5 years ago.
Regular marijuana use is preventing too many young people from reaching their full potential. THC, a key ingredient in marijuana, affects a region of the brain that's involved in memory. In fact, recent research shows that starting marijuana use during the teen years can reduce IQ and lead to reduced cognitive abilities.
While use has increased, perceived risk of marijuana harmfulness has dropped significantly from 5 years ago, to where less than half of 12th graders now see regular use of marijuana as harmful.
It's important to point out that adolescent marijuana use increases the risk for later addiction. About 1 in 6 teens that start using marijuana will become addicted. That risk goes up to 25% to 50% among daily users.
When it comes to prescription drug abuse, researchers report mixed results. While abuse of the prescription pain reliever Vicodin is down, it remains at unacceptably high levels. There was also an increase in the abuse of Adderall, a stimulant often prescribed to treat ADHD.
Many older teens believe that prescription stimulants like Adderall will help them take tests. In reality, there's little evidence of that, but a lot of evidence that it can cause harm. It can increase anxiety, affect heart rate, and be addictive.
This marked the first time the survey measured teen abuse of bath salts, and the second year researchers examined abuse of synthetic marijuana, also known as spice or K2.
What we've learned over the past couple of years, is that synthetic marijuana, that's K2 and spice, is quite common. Around 11% of high school seniors report using these potentially very dangerous substances. Bath salts, which are another very dangerous substance, are used by about 1 in 100, about 1% of high school students.
As for illicit drugs other than marijuana, the survey found usage at its lowest levels for all three grades. One promising trend was the drop in ecstasy use by high school seniors. It fell from 5.3% to 3.8% in 1 year.
NIDA will continue to do research to better understand drug abuse and addiction and how to prevent and treat it, and to get that information to teens, parents, anybody who can influence them so that they can make healthier decisions.
More than 45,000 8th, 10th, and 12th graders participated in this year's Monitoring the Future survey. To learn more, visit drugabuse.gov.